We've also gotten involved with some universities across our region that have construction programs. This is one of my favorite things. We come and speak to their students each year about the state of the industry, what's going on in the real world, resume writing, career planning, like what segment of the industry do they want to build their career around? Commercial construction, industrial construction, residential construction, or civil construction? What type of company do they want to work for? Big company, small company, maybe a local company or a regional company, national or worldwide if they have a desire to travel. Do they want to work for a general contractor or a real estate developer, a subcontractor, or even an end user? And then what career path do they want to pursue once they've made those decisions? Do they want to go into project management or field operations, pre-construction, business development, or virtual design construction? We spend a really large amount of time talking about how then to prepare for interviews. We tell them to research the company's website, their newsletters, search for blogs, setting up Google alerts for the companies that they're interested in so that they get any new information right to their inbox. While it might seem like a no-brainer for you and me, or even candidates that are veterans in the business, we talk with them about cleaning up their social media accounts before interviews. No matter how private they think they are, they're not. We talk to them about looking the part. Dressing well and appropriate makes a big difference, as well as having a firm handshake. We help them prepare for the "what's your weakness" question. You know that's questions coming, whether you've been in the business 20 years or you're fresh out of college. And like I said earlier, thank you notes, they're important. So we remind them that no matter how interested in the position they are, a personal thank you note afterwards, even over email, goes a long way. Then we spend a lot of time talking about what the bosses are saying about recent graduates they've hired. This information is so important because it's coming straight from our clients. They spend a lot of time telling us the good and the bad that they've seen with some recently hired college students. Hopefully, we can help them avoid some of the mistakes of their other industry newcomers. After our presentation's done, we spend time one-on-one talking about their specific companies they're interested in. We even review their resumes. In fact, the most asked question, year in and year out though, is about negotiating offers. All these college students think that they're gonna be inundated with multiple offers, and sometimes they are. So we spend time coaching them on how best to handle a multiple offer scenario. While a couple $1,000s might seem like a big difference to them now, we try to help them see that it's the company that should really carry the most weight. If the company can give you what you want out of your career and has a great culture, the money will come in the future. It's also important for us to explain to them what recruiters do and what to expect when they start getting calls. While we hope they'll develop a relationship with us, right, moving forward, it's imperative to tell them to find a recruiter that they trust that can help advise them throughout their career, whether it's making career moves, or maybe it's just about how to prepare for a review or to ask for a raise. We want to be a resource for them, but if it can't be us, we want to coach them on how to find a good one. We don't get paid for any of this, but really, it's one of the most rewarding things we do all year. Although, actually, I will tell you that the students do keep in touch with us, and we've even placed a few throughout the years. So maybe we do get paid for it, it's just not immediate. And you know, the professors really appreciate it. So do the kids. It's our way of giving back, and it's much easier than you would think to get involved in something like this. Search the universities near you that offer degree programs in your niche. The department heads and professors' contact information is almost always online.